show that f of x is equals to 3x plus 1 is integrable on the closed interval 1 comma 2 and integral from 1 to 2 3x plus 1 into dx is equals to 11 by 2. Solution: f of x is equals to 3x plus 1 is bounded on the closed interval 1 comma 2. That is, when you keep x is equals to 1, we get 3 into 1 plus 1 is 4. When you keep x is equals to 2, we get 3 2s are 6 plus 1 equal to 7. Therefore, 4 less or equals to f of x less or equal to 7 for all x belong to the closed interval 1 comma 2. That is, when you keep x is equals to 1, we get 3 plus 1 equal to 4. When you keep x is equals to 2, we get 6 plus 1 equal to 7. That is, f of x takes the value from 4 to 7. Therefore, the given function f of x is equals to 3x plus 1 is bounded on the closed interval 1 comma 2. Let us consider the partition P is equals to x0 equal to a comma x1 comma x2 comma so on, xr minus 1 comma xr comma so on, xn equals to b, where x0 is the first point of division, x1 is the second point of division, x2 is the third point of division, xr minus 1 is the rth point of division, x suffix r is the r plus 1th point of division, x suffix n is the n plus 1th point of division. Thus, the partition P consists of n plus 1 partition points. First point of division is nothing but x0 equal to a, that is always taken as the first value of the given interval, that is x0 equals to a, that is equals to 1. How to find the second point of division, namely x1? The second point of division can be obtained by the formula a plus b minus a by n. A is the first value of the interval and b is the end point of the given interval. Since we divide the given interval into n equal parts and hence we have a b minus a by n. Therefore, the second point of division x1 will be the first point of division plus b minus a by n, that is equal to 1 plus 2 minus 1 by n, because a is 1, b is 2, that is 2 minus 1 by n, that is equal to 1 plus 1 by n is the second point of division. Then the third point of division, namely x2, will be a plus 2 times b minus a by n, that is equal to 1 plus 2 by n. Now, what is the r plus 1th point of division? R plus 1th point of division is xr. This can be obtained by the formula a plus r into b minus a by n, that is equals to a is 1, r into b is 2 minus a is 1 by n, that is equal to 1 plus r by n. Then what is the last point of division, xn? That is nothing but the n plus 1th point of division is the last value of the given interval b, that is x suffix n, that can be obtained by the formula a plus n into b minus a by n, that is equals to 1 plus n into 2 minus 1 by n, that is equal to 1 plus 1 equals to 2. What is 2? Nothing but the last point of division. Thus, the first point of division must be 1 and the last point of division must be 2. That is, the first point of division must be the first value of the given interval and the last point of division must be the end point of the given closed interval. Thus, The first point of division is 1. Second point of division is 1 plus 1 by n. The third point of division is 1 plus 2 by n. So on r plus 1 to point of division is 1 plus r by n. And n plus 1 to point of division is 2. That is p equals to the first point of division is 1. Second point of division is 1 plus 1 by n. The r plus 1 to point of division, namely xr, is equal to 1 plus r by n. And the n plus 1 to point of division, namely x suffix n, is equals to 2. Thus the partition is 1 comma 1 plus 1 by n comma 1 plus 2 by n comma 1 plus 3 by n, so on. 1 plus r minus 1 by n comma 1 plus r by n comma so on 2. So this is the partition we are going to consider here. What is IR? I suffix r stands for the rth sub interval. The rth sub interval is the closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr. This is the value of x suffix r minus 1. This is the value of x suffix r. And hence the rth sub interval is 1 plus r minus 1 by n comma 1 plus r by n, where r is equals to 1 to n. Length of each sub interval. The length of each sub interval is given by the formula b minus a by n. B is the second end point of the given interval. A is the starting point of the given interval. That is the positive difference of the given interval divided by n. Why we write n? Because we divide the interval 1 comma 2 into n equal parts. Therefore, the length of each sub interval is b minus a by n, or the simple formula is second point of division minus the first point of division, that is equals to the second point of division is 1 plus 1 by n minus the first point of division is 1. If you take the difference, we get 1 by n. Therefore, length of each sub interval is b minus a by n. B is 2, a is 1 by n, that is 2 minus 1 by n is 1 by n, or the simple formula is second point of division minus first point of division, because both give the same answer. Since f of x is equals to 3x plus 1 is an increasing function on the given closed interval 1 comma 2, capital M R stands for supremum of the function in the rth sub interval. Since f of x is increasing function, capital M R will be f of x R. That is equals to f of xr value is 1 plus r by n. Therefore, f of 1 plus r by n. What is f of x? F of x is 3x plus 1. Now, in the place of x, we are going to write 1 plus r by n. And hence, it is 3 into x is 1 plus r by n plus 1. If you multiply this factor by 3, we get 3 plus 3r by n plus 1. 3 plus 1 is 4. So 4 plus 3r by n, where r equal to 1 to n. Therefore, the supremum of the function f in the rth sub interval is 4 plus 3r by n. If you want to find the supremum of the first sub interval I1, then it will be 4 plus 3, r is 1, so 3 by n, that is 4 plus 3 by n. If you want the supremum of the 10th sub interval, that is r equals to 10, and hence it is 4 plus 3 into 10, 30 by n, that is 4 plus 30 by n. Like that, we find the supremum of each and every sub interval. But in the formula, we are going to take capital MR. Therefore, capital MR is the supremum of the function f in the rth sub interval that is equals to 4 plus 3 small r by n. Now small mr is the infimum of f in the rth sub interval that is given by the formula f of xr minus 1. For supremum f of xr, for infimum f of xr minus 1, reason is f of x is an increasing function. That is f of xr minus 1. What is f of xr minus 1? F of 1 plus r minus 1 by n. What is f of 1 plus r minus 1 by n? We know that f of x is 3x plus 1. And hence, replace x by 1 plus r minus 1 by n. We get 3 into 1 plus r minus 1 by n plus 1. That is equals to multiply the factor by 3. We get 3 plus 3 into r minus 1 by n plus 1. 3 plus 1 equal to 4 plus 3 r minus 1 by n. See the difference between capital MR and small MR. The only difference is here it is R. In small MR it is R minus 1. We shall now find upper dot box sum, that is u of p comma f, that is equals to sigma r is equal to 1 to n capital MR into delta r. Capital MR is the supremum of the function f in the rth sub interval, that is equal to f of xr, and delta r is the length of the rth sub interval. Just now we have found the values of capital MR and delta r. We will now substitute those values here. That is equals to sigma r is equal to 1 to n capital MR is 4 plus 3 r by n, delta r is 1 by n. We will now multiply 4 plus 3 r by n with the factor 1 by n. If we multiply, we get sigma r equal to 1 to n 4 into 1 by n plus 3 r by n into 1 by n. That is equals to, now we will distribute the summation to both terms. That is sigma r equal to 1 to n 4 by n plus sigma r equal to 1 to n 3 r by n squared, because the summation is distributive. That is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to n 4 by n plus sigma r equal to 1 to n 3 by n squared into r. We are written like this because 3 by n squared is a constant. Here the only variable is r. Therefore, in the first term, 4 by n is constant. In the second term, 3 by n squared is constant. Therefore, the next step, we will take these constants out. That is 4 by n into sigma r is equal to 1 to n into 1. When you take 4 by n out, we are left with the number 1 plus 3 by n squared into sigma r equal to 1 to n r. We know that summation r equal to 1 to n c, where c is a constant. C is a constant, that is equal to c into n. Because here there is no r at all. There is no r at all. Therefore, we have c into n. That is sigma r equal to 1 to n 1. That is, we have to write this 1 n times. That is equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus so on n terms. That is equals to n. And hence, the value of summation r equal to 1 to n 1 is n. Also, sigma r equal to 1 to n r is equals to, put r equal to 1, we have 1 plus, because summation is there, summation is nothing but plus, so So plus r equal to 2 plus then r equal to 3, so on, r is equals to n, and this is sum of first n natural numbers, and we know that the sum of first n natural numbers is equals to n into n plus 1 by 2. Therefore, the upper dot box sum UPF is equals to 4 by n into n plus 3 by n squared into n into n plus 1 by 2. That is equals to 4 by n into n plus 3 by n squared. Now, our aim is to eliminate the maximum power of n, and hence there is 1 n here, and to take 1 n out from the factor, namely n plus 1, then we get n into n is n squared. We will get 1 plus 1 by n by 2. Now this n get cancelled, n square get cancelled. Therefore, that is equals to 4 plus 3 into 1 plus 1 by n by 2. That is equals to 4 plus 3 by 2 into 1 plus 1 by n is the upper dot box sum. We know that upper Riemann integral is defined as integral from a to b bar f of x dx. Here b bar stands for upper Riemann. That is equals to infimum of u of p comma f. To get the infimum of u of p comma f, we simply take the limit. That is limit n tends to infinity u of p comma f. That is equals to integral from 1 to 2 bar, because a value is 1, b value is 2, f of x dx is equals to limit n tends to infinity 4 plus 3 by 2 into 1 plus 1 by n. That is, integral from 1 to 2 bar, f of x is a given function, 3x plus 1 into dx is equals to, when you apply limit as n tends to infinity, wherever n is there, we write n tends to infinity, and we know that limit n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0, because 1 by infinity that tends to 0. And hence we have the upper Riemann integral of 3x plus 1 from 1 to 2 is equals to 4 plus 3 by 2 1 plus, this is value 0, that is equal to 4 plus 3 by 2, that is 8 plus 1 by 2, it is 11 by 2, we call it as 1. That is the upper Riemann integral of the function 3x plus 1 from 1 to 2 is 11 by 2. We shall now find the lower dot box sum L of P comma F, that is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to n small m r into delta r. Small m suffix r is the infimum of the function f in the rth subinterval. Delta r is the length of the rth subinterval. That is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to n. Small m r value is 4 plus 3 into r minus 1 by n. Delta r value is 1 by n. That is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to n. We multiply this factor with 1 by n, and hence it is 4 by n plus 3 into r minus 1 by n into n is n squared. That is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to n 4 by n plus sigma r equal to 1 to n 3 r minus 1 by n squared, because the summation is always distributive. That is equals to sigma r equal to 1 to n 4 by n plus sigma r equal to 1 to n 3 by n squared into r minus 1. We have written like this because the only variable is here r, and hence 4 by n in the first term and 3 by n squared in the second term are constant. Now, to apply the summation, we will take the constants out. That is equals to 4 by n into sigma r equal to 1 to n 1 plus 3 by n squared sigma r equal to 1 to n into r minus 1. We know that sigma r equal to 1 to n, c equal to c in the n. Therefore, sigma r equal to 1 to n 1 is nothing but n. Also, sigma r equal to 1 to n r minus 1 is equals to, when you keep r equals to 1, we get 1 minus 1 equal to 0. That is the first term. Because of this sigma, we have plus. Now keep r equal to 2. Therefore, it is 2 minus 1 is 1. That is the second term. For third term, r equal to 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. So on. And the last term is r equal to n. That is r minus 1 becomes n minus 1. And this is the sum of first n minus 1 natural numbers. Therefore, the formula is n minus 1 into n minus 1 plus 1 by 2. That is equals to n minus 1 into n by 2. And hence, the sigma r equal to 1 to n r minus 1 value is n into n minus 1 by 2. The lower dot box sum is equals to 4 by n into n plus 3 by n squared into n into n minus 1 by 2. That is equals to 4 by n into n plus 3 by n squared. As we did in the upper dot box sum, we have to take maximum n out and eliminate the maximum power of n so that it is very easy to find the limit. Therefore, there is 1 n here, and take 1 n out from the factor n minus 1, and hence we get n into n is n squared. When we take n out from n minus 1, that becomes 1 minus 1 by n by 2. That is equals to n can cancel. That is equals to 4 plus 3 by 2 into 1 minus 1 by n. Now we will find the lower Riemann integral of the given function. That is integral a bar to b f of x dx. This a bar stands for lower Riemann. That is equals to supremum of L of p comma f. That is supremum of all the lower dot box sums. That is equals to limit n tends to infinity L of p comma f. That is equals to integral 1 bar to 2 3x plus 1 dx, because a value is 1, b value is 2, and the given function f of x is 3x plus 1. That is equals to limit n tends to infinity L of p comma f is 4 plus 3 by 2 into 1 minus 1 by n. If you recall the upper Riemann sum for the same function, it was 4 plus 3 by 2 1 plus 1 by n. So generally the difference will be, in upper it is plus, in the lower it will be minus. That is equals to integral 1 bar to 2 3x plus 1 dx is equals to, when you apply limit as n tends to infinity, the factor namely 1 by n tends to 0. Therefore, this equals to 4 plus 3 by 2 into 1 minus 0. That is equal to 4 plus 3 by 2. Take LCM, it is 8 plus 3, 11 by 2. Let us call it as 2. From 1 and 2, we have integral from 1 to 2 bar 3x plus 1 dx is 11 by 2 and the integral 1 bar to 2 3x plus 1 into dx is equal to 11 by 2. That is the upper Riemann integral value is 11 by 2 and the lower Riemann integral value is also 11 by 2. That is the lower Riemann integral is equals to upper Riemann integral and each is equals to 11 by 2. Therefore, we say that the function f of x is equals to 3x plus 1 is integrable on the closed interval 1 comma 2 and the integral from 1 to 2 3x plus 1 dx is equals to 11 by 2. That is f belongs to R of the closed interval 1 comma 2. That means f is Riemann integrable on the closed interval 1 comma 2. Procedure to evaluate integral of a function using upper Riemann integral and lower Riemann integral. Step 1. Divide the given interval, the closed interval a comma b, into n equal parts and write its partition p. Normally p is equals to x naught equal to a. A is the first value of the given interval and x naught is the first point of division. Then x1, x2, so on, xr, so on, xn, xn will be the last value of the given closed interval. Thus the first point of division is a and the last point of division is b. And this partition will be having n sub-intervals and n plus 1 points of divisions, namely x0, x1, x2, so on, xr, so on, xn. Step 2. Write down the rth sub-interval ir. We know ir is equals to the closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr. Step 3 is to find the length of each subinterval. Let us take delta I. I is from 1 to n because we have n subinterval. It is given by the formula b minus a by n. That r, we can use another short formula, second point of division minus first point of division. This is much easier to get the value of delta I. Step 4 is to find supremum of f in the rth subinterval, namely capital MR, its value is f of xr, and the infimum of the function f in the rth subinterval, small mr, is equals to f of xr minus 1. Step 5 is to find upper Darboux sum and lower Darboux sum. Step 6 is to evaluate upper Riemann integral using this formula and lower Riemann integral using this formula. Thus, step 1 is to write the partition P. Step 2 is to write down IR. Step 3 is to find delta R. Step 4 is to find capital MR and small MR. Step 5 is to find UPF and LPF. And the last step is to find upper Riemann integral and lower Riemann integral. If the upper Riemann integral is equals to lower Riemann integral, we conclude that the given function is Riemann integrable on the given closed interval. 6 steps are involved here. The first step is to find the partition. Second step is to write IR. Third step is to find delta R or delta I. Fourth step is to find capital MR and small MR. Fifth step is to find upper dot box sum and lower dot box sum. Sixth step is to find the upper Riemann integral and lower Riemann integral.